I had the chance to talk with Dr. Graham Kent. He's the director of the seismology lab at the University of Nevada, Reno, over on the other side of the Sierra where this earthquake happened. And he told me when he looked at the shake map shortly after these quakes started that what he saw looked fairly textbook, but that should concern us because of the fault this happened to happen on.
This is a classic aftershock sequence. So you'll get maybe a 6, and then you get a 4, and then some 3s, and a 3.5, and then you get another 4, and then you get some 2s, and it just bounces around. Now, occasionally, maybe in our area, maybe upwards of 20-25% of the time, it could be a 4-shock for a bigger earthquake an hour down the road, a day, even a month. The probabilities get less and less the further away you get away from it. But that was a big jolt. The last 5.9 we've had in the area was back in the mid-90s.
So you heard him say a 20 to 25% chance that this could be actually a foreshock of a bigger quake to come just by virtue of where it's happening. For comparison, that's like a 1 in 4, 1 in 5 chance. He says that any old fault in planet Earth, you're looking at a 1 in 20 chance. So there is a higher degree of risk just by virtue of where the quake happened.